class, let us discuss about that division of labor and inequality in the employment, labor with pay and without pay, then organized workers, unorganized workers, and what are the problems of unorganized workers. These all are the very important for you. Yes, let us discuss about the lesson labor. Yes, the Plato. Plato is a great socialist and he is a great thinker. So in his book Republic, what is Plato? Is a great thinker. He wrote a book is called The Republic. In his book The Republic, he discussed about that division of labor. And he says that human society is formed on natural, that is, inequalities. These inequalities are based on division of labor. Understand? Plato is a great thinker. In his book The Republic, he says that human societies are formed on natural inequalities. In a sense, human society, our society have more natural inequalities physically and also mentally. Is it so? We have the more inequalities in our society. Naturally, we got by birth, the human society got the natural inequality. Is it so? These natural inequalities are based on division of labor. Understand? So these natural inequalities are based on division of labor. Yes, here division of labor is a very necessary for every society. Yes, here society needs are fulfilled by the, what is, division of labor. What is society needs of the society is fulfilled by the division of labor. Yes, let us discuss about that example about that. Yes, we are wearing the clothes now. So, before the more division of labor we can see. So, what is that? Here, farmers grows the cotton. Is it? So, farmers grows the cotton and weavers weave. And in a sense, weavers are converted that cotton into the cloth. Okay? Then next is, here the tailor give the structure for the cloth. Finally, that is, we wearing the dresses. Understand this? So, this a work divided into the various, people. Dividing the various people according to their age, talent, skill, gender, ability. So, this is called the division of labor. Understand this? So, division of labor means dividing the work on the basis of skill, education, talent, age, then afterwards ability is called division of labor. Yes, here already I explained, no? Here farmer grows the cloths, then afterwards farmers grow the cotton, then afterwards weaver is weaving the cloths. This is cotton converting into the cloth. Then afterwards tailors gives the structure to the cloth, what we want, which type of the design we need. Is it that type of the cloth is prepared by the tailor? So this is called the division of labor. See here, the skill is specified. Is it weavers is not know about that how to grow the cotton, tailor don't know about that how to weave the cloths. Is it similarly here, the farmer don't know about that how to, what is, stitch the cloth. Is it? So similarly, every person have their own skill. Is it? On the basis of their talent, skill, age, ability is called. This is called, what it is? Division of labor. Understand? So division of labor is to fulfill the needs of the society. Understand? See here, cotton grown by the, what is, farmer, he fulfilled the need indirectly. Is it? Similarly, the weaver, he converted the cloth into the cotton. He is also indirectly fulfilled the need of the society. Then afterwards, tailor, he is also giving the structure. Is it? He is stitching the cloth through that. It is very helpful to wear. Is it? So through that, every person, every division of labor, without the cotton, there is no cloth and no tailor. Is it? There is no cloth means cotton is waste and there is no tailor. Is it? There is no tailor means we are not wearing the good and varieties of cloths. Is it? So here all division of labor, the farmer, weaver and also the home, it is tailor. These division of labors are fulfill the needs of the society. Understand this? Yes, division of labor is very necessary for every society. And it leads. What is division of labor leads to the? What is cooperation of the people and technical? What is it? It is leads to the technical and cooperation of the people. It is very necessary. But here there is a no discrimination and exploitation. That is, it is in this there is a no discrimination and no exploitation. This is called the division of labor. Understand this concept? Yes, here division of labor. It means what is dividing the peoples on the basis of the talent, skill, age, ability, is it? So this is called dividing the work, not the people. Dividing the work on the basis of the people's quality, skill, ability, education, talent, age, gender is called the division of labor. Yes, then next let us discuss about that. Here the Karl Marx. He explains in his book about that the division of labor is creates the less skill laborers. What is it? He explains about that less skill workers. Yes, yeah. The Karl Marx explains about that. What is it? Less skill division of labor is creates the less skill workers. Is it? Here the person is not having the complete knowledge about that how to grow the cotton, how to stitch and how to convert the cotton into the what is cloth, is it? A single person not know about that. Every person have the specific knowledge about the every stage, is it? For example, here the farmer, he know the knowledge about that how to grow the cotton, is it? That is only specific, less skill, in the sense only specific skill he have, only one skill he have, how to grow the cotton. Similarly here we can see that the weaver, he know that how to convert the cotton into the cloth, is it? He is only the one skill, but he is not know about that how to grow the cotton. For that purpose the Karl Marx is explains about that what is how to grow the it creates the less skilled workers. What is the less skilled workers? Afterwards the Karl Marx divide the labors into the two parts. First one is the social labors and second one is the economic labors. Karl Marx is divide the labors into the two parts, the social labors and economic labors. Yes, here this labor, in a sense this division of labor creates the less skilled peoples. Then afterwards we can see that it leads for the what is the class, status and stratification. What is it? This creates the class, status and also the classification. Understand? So this is all about the opinion of Karl Marx about the division of labor. Yes, let us discuss about that. The division of labor is different from the post information technological period to present information technology. In a sense, the present fast growing technology, now we are seeing the information technology. So this is olden days to now digital days. What is this division of labor is changed from the past to present division of labor. Is here nowadays division of labor on the basis of computer, on the basis of technology, is it? It is on the basis of technology. How it is on the basis of the technology? For example, here every computer technology is different, is it? So it is how the different kinds of the technology we can see in the various versions also, is it? In the specific field also, see here the in the engineering, civil is there, EE electronics is there, is it? Likewise the varieties of branches is there, no, in the what is in the engineering. Similarly here in the computer also we can see that the varieties of technologies is there, is it? Well, varieties of information technology branches is there. We are going through that, is it or not? Similarly, for example, we are the human being, no? When we get the disease, for that purpose, we are going for that, we are want to going to get the treatment with the doctor, we are going for the concerned doctor, is it? If we have the problems of the bone, so we are going to the and we meet to the artho, is it? And for the it is the sickness of the children, we are moving for the pediatrist, is it? Similarly here also for the women, we are going for the gynecologist, is it? So here when how we have the different branches in the medical, similarly here also we having the different branches in the technology, information technology. We are moving through that. Understand this, we are moving through that. Civil is there, then electronics is there, computer science is there. So through that we are moving through the different branches of information technology and software also. Understand this? Then this division of labor creates the specialization. Understand, see here the MD and surgeons are doing the operations. Pediatrists know about that, what is illness and diseases about the children, is it? Then gynecologists, they have the knowledge about that how to treat the diseases for women, is it? Then orthos, they know that how to treat for the bones, is it? So likewise here also they get the specialization in a particular field. Understand, they got the specialization about the particular field. So here division of labor creates the specialization in the particular field. Already I discussed about this. Likewise, a farmer know about that how to grow the cotton. He only specialization in the growing of cotton. Understand? Not the weaving and not the tailoring. Is it? So likewise here also in the division of labor, every person have the specialization in the particular field. What is the specialization? What is the specialization? As here, the specialization means having the deepest knowledge in a particular field. What is having the deepest knowledge in the particular field is called the specialization. As division of labor is creates the what is specialization. Understand this? Yes, here specialization is a very need for fulfill the need of society, for economical need, political need and social need also fulfilled by this division of labor. Understand this? Yes. Then here specialization is also helpful for the earn the more benefits, is it? To earn the more benefits. So this division of labor creates the class system. What is it? Is creates the class system. Yes. And it goes through the what is the class status and stratification also creates by this social stratification. Yes, by this only the few people investing the and investing in the industrialization and getting the more profit and earning the more income. Understand this? So here we can see that this division of labor is creates the what is industrialization. What is it? Creates the industrialization. Understand this? So this is all about that division of labor. I think you are understanding about this topic. Division of labor is on the basis of age, on the basis of interest, on the basis of gender and talent. Then afterwards ability, skill, taste and special skill. In a sense, divide the people on the basis of age, on the basis of interest, gender, talent, ability, skill, taste and special skill is called division of labor.